Hey, what's up, man?
Nah, I was just texting you. You must be psychic.
I guess so, man. What's going on?
Not much. What are you up
to? Actually, I was calling you because I have a slight change of plans for tomorrow. I know we're supposed to hook up at the gym tomorrow morning, but I got a slight change of plans.
All right.
Hi.
Hello.
I would. Is it too early for me for the weigh-in for tomorrow's meet?
Yeah. What's your name?
Ken Bray.
I was thinking about it, and I got to look at that competition, and I think I'm gonna show up, but I'm gonna be in that competition.
The gentleman in the back is gonna weigh you. You can just hang out here if you.
Which one? Tomorrow?
Yeah.
So only 2 weeks after state championships, with no warning, no train up, no prep, no rest or break in training cycle, and about 16 hours notice, I decide just at the spur of the moment to enter a competition.
Go, boy, are you serious?
Yeah, I did my way in tonight, and I'll be there at 8:15. Yeah, man, this should be fun, man. And the crazy thing is, this will be my first time competing in this league. And I got a really good shot at breaking, like, 3 national records tomorrow.
No shit.
Since this particular competition was governed by a league other than my home league, I thought to myself, there was no pressure to be perfect. I went into it very loose and relaxed. Maybe even a bit too loose and relaxed. Since there was no pressure and no expectations, my strategy was easy. Everything, balls to the wall.
Squat might as well have been feathers. I was so relaxed in the zone that by the time my second squat came around, I didn't even realize that I was completely out of uniform. And I didn't even notice the head referee frantically trying to get my attention to fix before I started my squat. Of having to redo my uniform while on the platform had no bearing on the fact that that went up and went down, and just like that.
That tied the national record, but my next one is I'm going to try to beat it by...
And you got that up and down like there's no tomorrow.
Yeah, and that was taken into account. I had to change my clothes, take my belt off. Yeah, dude, I just looked. They put me in the fight with all the fucking monsters. Why'd y'all put me in the play with all of the heavyweights?
Why? Yeah. Oh, because you're having nothing.
Oh, that is the correct answer.
So relaxed at a moment like this, where I could actually talk to the announcer and to people in the crowd and still destroy the fucking lift. And just like that, national record gone. UPA rules state that if a national record has been broken and there's a possibility of setting a world record,
a fourth attempt must be given to the lifter. I didn't realize this, and so I said, give me 500 pounds.
Yeah, we'll be clocking, ma.
We be clocking mucho, loco, peso. Bolas for your cash up, cause I said so. And if you're clocking O's and you're stacking dough, then you can roll, roll.
We'll be clocking, ma.
Mucho peso.
And why they throw them hands up?
Cause I said so.
And if you're clocking O's
and you're stacking dough,
then you can do what? Can I hit you with them big ones, ma? Not them big guns, why would you wanna resist him with the icy wrist? Who get the model chicks? Who pop the crisps? Who got the club hits? Who spit the hot shit?
The bench press has always been my weakest lift. But on this day, even the bench press was exciting. 255 pounds move like nothing. Bolas throw your cash up, cause I say so. And if you're clocking O's and you're stacking dough, 275 pounds. Nothing. And even though just 2 weeks prior at state championships, I failed at it. 285 pounds. Fuck you. Bring on the deadlift.
Some get 'em to work, some get 'em to hoe, some get 'em to ride, some get 'em to show, some get 'em kids, some get 'em school. What you sitting on, nigga? Some get 'em forward, some get 'em messed, some get 'em wait, some get 'em rest, some get 'em switch, some get 'em bitch. What you sitting on, nigga?
Through them 21-inch blades, cut the ground up when you press the gas pedal down, huh?
Yes.
Do you give a fuck about gas mileage when you roll up on the college and them poet hoes smile at you?
Yes.
Use a riding nigga with that great digger under the seat hitting so you can get it quicker.
Yes.
Summer's coming so your shit can't be home, huh? Gotta feel the thump 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 from the kick drum.
By the time I got to my final deadlift, I was at a point I didn't expect to be at. I was staring 600 pounds in the face with plenty left in the tank. Except I didn't want to hit it outside of my home league. So I backed it off and opted for 595.
Now go.
Okay, in the Brahmins Masters, ages 45 through 49, in first place we have Ken Bray.
That's me. All right.
So in a little gym in Brookpark, Ohio, at a local meet that wasn't supposed to matter, far away from the scrutiny and pressure of the national spotlight, I relearned one of the most valuable lessons. As an athlete, take a deep breath, relax, have fun, and just pick the fucking bar up.
Let's go. What you sitting on, nigga? Some get 'em to work, some get 'em to hoe, some get 'em to ride, some get 'em to show, some get 'em kid, some get 'em store. What you sitting on, nigga? Some get 'em forward, some get 'em messed, some get 'em wait, some get 'em rest, some get 'em switch, some get 'em bitch. What you sitting on, nigga?
Through them 21-inch blades, cut the ground up when you press the gas pedal down, huh?
Yes.
Do you give a fuck about gas mileage when you roll up on the college and then